Hi guys, welcome back. So we successfully implemented the form feature and it submits. It works like a native HTML form. When you submit, it refreshes the page, which we may not want. So we have something called use enhance that action, which can be used in here. So it already did the import for us. So that will avoid all that. So let's say I don't submit that, I do this and then I enter some message. It should not refresh and give me what's happening here. So it did give me that name is missing. If I add the name and everything, it should reset. Yeah. So the page is not refreshing. Okay. So that was it. Now let's fix some of these things. So form submitted. When we see that form is submitted, we may not want to see the entire form. So let's do something. So after contact us, now if not, or maybe we need it, right? So let's see what happens here. Form is submitted, but we may want to send something else as well. So let's say success true. All right. Let's imagine we are sending that. Now here in the form, if form can have a condition form, I'll have a question mark there, so because it may not be present. Success. If it is true, then show this, right? Else show this entire thing, the form thing, and we can end the if here. Okay, let's hope it's all aligned properly. Yeah, okay, so that is done. Now here we want to have class success, maybe, I don't know, I'll have that. I will style that dot success be color green, maybe light green, I don't know if that is the thing. Yeah. So when it is success, we show it in light green. So when form is not submitted, right? I mean, like something is missing, right? When name is missing, we are also sending it as status, name is missing. So let's send it as an error, right? Instead of status, let's go here, error, name is missing, error, name is missing. Okay, maybe we should using this, maybe we can style the form itself and show some other thing here. Let's say initially form.name is not present. Eventually it'll come back. Okay, so class is error, add error class if form is present and not form.name. Okay, so maybe this should work because form is there but form name is not there, so maybe it will add that. So let's try this submit. Let me inspect whether error is added. Form control error, yeah, error is there. I can use that for others, maybe. This will be email. Oh, this is a very maybe an edge case. You don't really need this, but this will be useful for somebody who is entering the form. So border, one fix solid red. So when this happens, now we see that the name is there. User will immediately know which field has the error. They can enter the data. Now we are not sending error for all these. So let's say we do something like not email. You should be doing a validation for email. There are validators available, third-party validators available, or you can use a regex or something. But either way, you should validate most of your fields, except if they are optional. If not message, you say message is missing. But while sending it back here, if email is missing, you will send only name, and here you will not send the message. Okay, that will be missing. So anyway, so maybe when we don't send back the message, we don't have to because it's missing. All right. In case of validating, you may have to send it back because they may want to change. Let's say they entered some wrong email and they submit. You should be sending back the email they entered so that they can fix it, right? So that's something. But anyway, so in this case, we are not going to bother about that. So let's say I enter the name, I enter some message, my email is missing. When I submit, it shows my email is missing. I enter the email, I miss the message and submit. It has a red border around it and says, you know, it's missing. There was also a message which should have shown, but it's fine. We don't really have to show it in this case. It's all right. So our contact form is working as expected. Maybe at some point, maybe I can show it in the next one. Maybe, I don't know. So how to send email using SMTP, but I don't think it needs to be covered here. But yeah, so we finished most of our project here, from creating this beautiful homepage to fetching data and using this active state in the navbar. We didn't create these pages; they are just content, you know. So I will add that whenever and update it. So I don't need to go through all that. So subscribe, guys. I'll be doing a lot of these. So thank you. Bye-bye.